4. Hello everybody, my name is Anmol Birring and today's topic is acoustic impedance and transmission through interfaces. This is a little bit advanced topic, so I will try to explain it slowly. But make sure, just focus on these formulas. So what we are trying to talk is that what happens to sound when it crosses interfaces. So here we have water and steel, and here is a pulse coming, sound pulse, acoustic pulse P1, which has a pressure P. So we are going to be talking about the pressure of the pulse, and then we will use this pressure, and then we will use these formulas to calculate how much pressure is transmitted and how much is reflected. So when this pulse P1 comes here at this boundary of water steel, it's here P1, and then right here is the reflected pulse P2, and the transmitted pulse is P3. So P2 equals to the reflected one, which is Z2 minus Z1 divided by Z2 plus Z1. What is Z2 and Z1? They are the acoustic impedance. This is medium number one, this is medium number two. So Z2 is the acoustic impedance of steel, which is here 46 newton second per meter cube. Z1 is the acoustic impedance of water, which is on this side, and which is 1.48 newton second per meter cube. Now, upon this reflection and transmission, the boundary conditions have to match, which means that the pressure on this side has to match the pressure on this side, which means that P1 plus P2, which is here P1 plus P2, has to match equal to P3. So it's kind of like you're coming here and they are both against each other. So the pressure from left side and the right side has to match. So if you look at it, so we have P1 plus P2, which is this one, equals to P3. P1 equals to P2, which is going to be the reflected signal, which is 0.938 here. And the transmitted pulse pressure is going to be 1.938 of P1. Now, one can ask, how come the pressure of the transmitted pulse is almost double the pressure of the incident pulse? And the reason is, that's because of the differences in the elastic modulus of water and steel. And we know the elastic modulus of steel is quite high. So when it gets transmitted, the pressure increases. And the reason we are actually considering pressure is because pressure is what is picked up by the UT probe. The pressure gets transferred into displacement, and then the UT crystal actually converts that displacement into the voltage pulse, which goes into the UT receiver of the UT machine. So we are actually that's the reason we talk about the pressure of the pulse. So that's going from water to steel, and then when we go from steel into water, this P3 is coming here, and you want to move here? P3 is coming here. So P3 is incident on this interface, and now we have P3, and then P4 is reflected, and P5 is actually the transmitted signal. So here we have P3, there should be a P4 here, but P3 plus P4 should be equal to P5. So what we have is P3 plus P4 equals to P5 to meet the boundary conditions. And here the transmitted signal is going to be again 2 times Z2, which is the water, and divided by Z2 plus Z1. So this comes out to be 0.062, which is very small, which is this P5 signal here. And then the reflected signal, the phase will flip. So that's going to be minus, so it's 1.48 minus 46 divided by this. So this one is negative, means that the phase has flipped. So you can see the P3 was a positive phase and P4 is a negative phase. So now P3 plus P4 should be equal to P5. So let's check. P3 and P4 is minus 938, which is this one, and equals to the transmitted signal, which is 0.062 P3, which is right here. So they balance. You know, the boundary condition on this side is P3 minus this one equals to 0.062 P3. So they are equal. So that matches. So now we are going to run a test in which I'm going to put a plate, a steel plate in water. So here we have a UT probe, and you can see from the UT probe, the pulse goes, this is a steel plate, this is water, again water here. So water, steel, water. Sound is coming from the UT probe, which is P1. The reflected sound is P2, which is on the left side. And then P3 is transmitted, P4 is reflected, and P5 actually goes back to the UT probe. So you have two signals coming. This P2, which we are going to call as signal number A1 on the UT screen, and the final signal, which goes from the water, steel, reflected from the steel water, and then transmitted back to the UT Pro P5. So that will be our A2 signal. So A1 comes from here, which is this reflected signal, 0.938 right here from water into steel, which is here. So we will call it A1 equals to 0.938 of P1. And what is A2? A2 is the transmitted signal here, which is this 1.938 P1. And then the reflected signal P4, which is here, and that's going to be minus 0.938. And then the sound will come here from steel into water, and then that will be our P5, which is the transmission from the steel into water, which is 0.062, which comes out to be 1.938 from here times this one, which is going to be the minus, should be minus here, 0.938 times 0.062. So that comes out to be 0.113 P1. So now we have the A1 is 0.938 P1 and the A2 is 0.113 P1. And then if you divide A2 over A1, it comes out to be 0.12. So what it means is that the signal which is coming from the back wall of the steel will be 12% of the signal coming from the front wall, which is A1. So A2 over A1 will be 12% of the A1. So now let's run a test to demonstrate this effect. And I have a steel plate in water, just a small demonstration. So which is right here. So here I have a demonstration, and in this one I have a UT probe here in and there is a steel plate in water, and you can see the signal here. This is the front wall signal A1, and that's a signal A2, and you can see the signal A2, which is coming from the back wall of the steel, is actually 12%. Here it says 12% of the front wall. So what it shows is that our theoretical calculation matches with the actual practical measurements to demonstrate, you know, how the what is the relevance of these calculations, and they really do work. So this, I can say that this is an advanced topic for ultrasonic testing, but impedance, understanding of the impedance, is extremely important to know how the sound transmits from one medium to another medium and another medium like that. And you know, there are many examples of this, or many applications for sound going from in cladded materials, from carbon steel to stainless steel, and if you have aluminum, so you know, like that. So I hope you got the idea of this transmission coefficient and reflection coefficient. And remember, this is actually pressure. These transmission coefficient and reflection coefficient pertain to the pressure of the pulse. And thank you very much. Thanks.